I want to slowly transition into a different topic here while we're talking about the Giro team of Jumbo.
Oh, yeah, true.
This morning, announcement by Jumbo-Visma and by Dylan Groenewegen that he's taking a spot in the Giro team, replacing the Chris Harper spot that was set up beforehand. So Dylan Groenewegen is starting a season not hiding in the Tour de Hungary, for example, but in full force in a Grand Tour and World Tour in the Giro d'Italia. I don't know. I don't know how it would influence their team dynamics, because this replaces a climbing rider that could have been supportive of Bennett with a pure sprinter that we are completely unknown of when it comes to his form, basically just as unknown towards Remco's form, for example. So those two are like complete unknowns going into the Giro. When it comes to Dylan, I hope that it doesn't take away an opportunity for Decker to get a stage win, because I called that stage win at the start of the season. And if Groenewegen gets all the chances now, I'm going to cry myself to sleep every single evening in the Giro.
Yeah, I'm pissed for two reasons. Firstly, I agree. Benji and I took out significant long hauls on David Decker's career.
I didn't. Not financial advice.
I did back in 2020. No, they don't exist, Benji. You can't take. There's no betting markets for that in cycling. But I was big on him last year. I thought, you know, stage two Giro, he was big chance for that sprint stage. And now Groenewegen is going. And secondly, I got the rights to the Tour de Hungary to show highlight videos, and I don't with the Giro d'Italia, so I'm fucked. Groenewegen was going to be a big draw card, you know, his first probably sprint stage win back at Tour de Hungary. And now, what am I left with?
Olaf Koy.
Yeah. I like Olaf Koy, actually. I think he's pretty
good. Me too.
But yeah, it's a shame for Decker, but maybe it's not Benji. Is he on lead out duties? Like, what do you think is going to happen? You kind of mentioned it. I think Decker is actually a really good lead out guy. Big guy, gets into, you know, into spaces, knows already how to move with a bunch. And they don't have much of a lead out. Affini, who doesn't do the last K at all, there's barely any lead out at all. So yep. I think Decker's better at looking after himself, to be honest. We saw it at UAE Tour. I think he can manage himself, no problems. Do you think Groenewegen's just going there, not like Jakobsen at Turkey, but with that principle and philosophy of just getting some racing in the legs?
I think that it's weird to send someone to the Giro for the first time without knowing that he's got a decent form. So I'm pretty sure that he's already hitting high numbers. Otherwise, they wouldn't replace the opportunity of like someone else getting into the Giro that has been pretty decent all season, for example. I think Harper's out because of an injury, but I'm not sure about it. So it is not like he's taking away the spot from Harper. But when it comes to being a lead out as a sprinter, it's not as simple as, he's a good sprinter, so he's going to be a good lead out. That's not really how it works. I think that a lot of good sprinters don't have the capabilities of becoming a good lead out, because some are just very aerodynamic and not big enough to kind of hide the rider behind him, but also other riders like Van der Poel, for example. The man can sprint like a maniac sometimes, but he's so much sprinting in bursts and moving up and down in bursts and going through corners and being treacherous throughout all these corners, meaning that the sprinter behind him has trouble following. And when you're doing that, then you're not going to be an ideal lead out, and we've seen that before with Van der Poel as well. So yeah, I think that Groenewegen is on paper the kind of rider that I would see able to have the abilities of doing a lead out. I just don't know what they're going to do. If Groenewegen is good enough to go to the Giro, then I expect him to sprint. And
yeah,
I would hope Decker to sprint. But you said it. Decker is kind of a good rider as a lead out as well, in the sense that his type of sprinting seems to be the kind of sprint you also can do well as a lead out with. And that's mainly because he has a, like you mentioned, I think, in your video, we keep running back to this old video of yours that you were talking about Davy Decker, where he has a limited time span of being out of the saddle in sprinting. We've seen that in UAE Tour perfectly. And I think this plays into the card of him being decent at a lead out role as well. But I just hope it isn't like that, because I'd love to see David Decker win a stage. Come on.
What I want to know is, did Groenewegen have something in his contract about going to the Tour this year? Or was he promised going to the Tour this year, and there was no spot in the team for him? Maybe that's more an Ackerman scenario. that I'm misremembering or conflating those two. So they say, oh, we'll send you the Giro instead. Honestly, Benji, I thought his suspension stopped him going to the Giro. I thought it ran over. It obviously doesn't. It expires beforehand. But people saying that suspension was too harsh, I mean, what did he miss? UAE Tour and Paris-Nice? Like, come on. Wasn't that bad, that suspension, really. I mean, I know it was 9 months, but it was backdated. Gets to slot in to the Giro straight away, which is fine. I'm just saying, I don't think the suspension was overboard. But that'll be a really interesting storyline, Benji. Can't wait to talk about it in our Giro preview show, which will be next Wednesday. In about a week, we'll hopefully drop it on time. So you've got enough time to watch it. They're usually absolute bangers before the Grand Tours, our most popular ones. If you want to see,
I love them.
They're so good. We'll have all the profiles and stuff on the YouTube channel, the podcast, and our faces, obviously, for the preview show.